as an artist myself, you know, I see in myself a tendency sometimes to think in the same way, you know, to think, to approach something in a way that I've been approaching it all along. And, you know, just sort of think that the solution to a problem is always, well, it's this kind of problem, so it's this. And the way that, I think it's brilliant the way that you come at things differently. That's what I mean by not thinking of things creatively the way that other people would get, you know, even just in the games, you know, the way, there's a lot of games that kind of all just go in this direction, and the way that you think about it is always very innovative, in my opinion.
28年間シリーズを紡ごうと思って、そんなことを計画的にできる人はいないと思うんですよね。毎回毎回これで最後で、これ以上のものは作れないという思いでやってきたんですけども、ふと振り返ってみると28年間やってたと。
All of the Metal Gears, but this one was special to me because of all the years of working with Harry and all the direction you guys had with that, and then also to be able to work directly for Hideo. And all I can say is it was an honor. There wasn't any bad for me whatsoever at any point.
One thing to say is that technology has continually improved, and games are especially so.同じことをやってた時じゃないんですよ。新しい技術が入って喋るようになって、立体になって、ムービーがかかるようになって、物理が入るようになって、でアクターさんの演技指導とかもするようになってっていうことなんで、僕の中では同じコンテンツですけど、常にこう階段を上がっていくとか、新しいものを取り入れてどんどんそうできることが広がっていったっていうのがあるので。
Well, for me, you know, I strive to find the balance in my life betweenwork and family and joy, you know, recreation, surfing, whatever it is. And I think that's everywhere in life, and video games certainly. It's very hard to, you can have every element, you can have a brilliant story, great actors, great animators, the whole thing can be perfect, but when it comes together, it's hard to tell how it's going to turn out. But I think you found a great balance, obviously, and great success with Metal Gear. For a long time, it came out amazing.
So, but literally, you have created something that has become so much bigger than what I think even you imagined it could be.Because so many of the great games that we have out right now, or the games that are being made right now, you inspire people to make a better game because of the games that you have created. So for me to be a part of that legacy, that legend, means more to me than you'll ever know. So thank you for the memories.
About this game, what stands out to me, it's the memories you make in the gameplay of the first time. So I, you know, I'm upgrading everything. I'm using my GMP, I'm upgrading my Fulton. I've been forever, like, I want to upgrade Mother Base. I want Mother Base to be awesome. So I'm driving and driving and driving and having the Fulton ready to carry out the cargo. And when I finally got it, I went out on my first side op, and it was like, it was the first of take out the tank artillery or whatever. And I come over the hill, and there's a tank sitting there with two guys on each side.And I was like, yes. And I snuck up behind him, choked out each one of the guys. Then before the tank had any idea, Fultoned out the tank right there. And I was like, this is a dream come true, because for 20 hours I've been dreaming of doing this.
It's fun for me because having, you know, written about games and cover games for so long,It's so predictable sometimes how people, you know, reveal information about games. And I love that, you know, games are about, like, you know, playing with people's emotions. And I think you do a great job in the marketing and positioning of the games. And it's fun for me. It's fun for the fans, right? I mean, what I love about it is it connects back to sometimes the themes of your games, and you really deeply think about these things. And that's what I like. It all comes from you as a creator. And some creators are very focused on just the game, but I think you think of the whole picture of sort of how you want to, you know, work with the fans and give them a journey along the way until they get to play the game. Because it's hard for a lot of these fans. They hear about the game, they have to wait years to be able to play it. So I think you always have fun with the fans as well. And I think they appreciate it.
まあ、ミッシングリンクの変換を保管するってことで、これあんまりまだゲームプレイされてない皆さんには言えないんですけど、どういう保管の仕方が、変換をつなぐ仕方がいいのかってずっとこう、まあ4ぐらいから考えてたんですけど、でその一つの答えが今回の、メタルギアソリッド5なので、ファンの方は多分喜んでもらえると思います。あの誰もがやったことないことをチャレンジしてますので、しかもゲームでしかできなかったことをしてますし、28年間というシリーズをじゃないと不可能なことをやっているので、まあ、ぜひ喜んでいただければと思います。
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, Nicole.
So this is for Sean's memory.
Thank you.
I've been the expert.
That's my father. Thank you.
昨年の12月、ショーンさんの、まあ、メールいただいて、で、まあ、開発の終盤ってすごく大変なことがいろいろあって、辛い思いをするんですけど、まあ、ショーンさんのメールを開発のスタッフと共有して、そういう勇気をもらったので、ようやく完成したということで、ショーンさんも僕らのスタッフの仲間ということで、そのお礼を兼ねて完成の報告をさせていただくということで。
Well, I wanted to thank him because Sean was very sick and he'd been doing chemo for so long that the medicine didn't make him feel better anymore. So he'd do a full day of chemo and he'd come home and he'd sit in front of the video games and he'd play and that would make him feel better. He could run and he could jump and he could do things that he couldn't do with his body anymore. So for him, it was a way of getting through the chemotherapy, so it was very important to us. And like I said, he was so thrilled when he got his gift. And, you know, it was 4 days he passed. But we sent that picture of you and you can see the smile on his face because he was so excited.
ショーン君って亡くなられたファンの方の報告に行きましたけど、僕のやっぱりこのエネルギーっていうのはやっぱりユーザーの皆さんですね。で、まあ、例えばメタルギアソリッド5をだいたいこの辺に発売しますと発表した限り、何があろうとどんなことがあろうとも皆さんの期待を超えるものを作らないと、まあ、僕の存在意味はないので、そこだけですね。で、そういう人たちからエネルギーをもらって、まあ、ここまで来れたので、そういう意味ではユーザーの皆さんとの、その一緒に作ってくれた仲間たちにはお礼を言いたかった。最後の最後まで、可能な限り、挑戦も含めて、メタルギアソリッド5を作り込みましたので、安心して遊んでいただけるものになっていると思います。結構長い間お待たせしましたけど、その、まあ、その全く甲斐がある仕上がりになっていると思いますので、ぜひ楽しんでください。本当にありがとうございました。